Those who have disregarded Ellen White have disregarded the below mentioned prophets and apostles. Moses, Samuel, Ezra, Nehemiah, David, Solomon, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, Daniel, Hosea, Joel, Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, Malachi, Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, Paul, James, Peter, and John. Those who have disregarded Ellen White have disregarded the Bible as well. During the time of Jesus, the Jews claimed to be the sons of Abraham, but they were longing to kill Jesus. Hence, Jesus told them they were not the children of Abraham, but rather the children of the devil. If they were truly the children of Abraham, they would have accepted Christ. Similarly, if someone has truly regarded the Bible, they will regard Ellen White as well. Many pastors and leaders disregard or undermine the writings of Ellen White. There are some, even elders, who say that the writings of Ellen White are less inspired than the Bible. From where has this false teaching entered our church? For more than 2 to 3 generations, our church has been taught this serious error. Hence, the members of our church have kept the prophet away, and hence are perishing, suffering in illness, and are pushed into utter darkness. During the time of Moses, couldn't the Israelites have told that we have Abraham, so we don't need you? Abraham is greater than you? During the time of Samuel, couldn't the Israelites have told that we have Moses, so we don't need you? Moses is greater than you? During the time of David, couldn't the Israelites have told that we have Samuel, a greater prophet, so we don't need you? During the time of Daniel, couldn't the Israelites have told that we have Isaiah and Jeremiah, greater prophets, so we don't need you? During the time of Paul, couldn't the early church have told Paul that we have Moses, Samuel, David, Isaiah, Jeremiah, and Daniel, and other prophets, so we don't need you? What do you think would have happened to the early church? In Selected Messages, Volume 1, page 32, it says, "Why have I not claimed to be a prophet? Because in these days, many who boldly claim that they are prophets are a reproach to the cause of Christ. And because my work includes much more than the word prophet signifies." Which means Ellen White was the greatest prophet the Lord has ever given to Israel. Yes, we have been given the greatest messenger by the Lord Himself. And if we had respected and accepted her, we would not be in this terrible apostasy as we are in today. If for any reason you have fallen for this great deception that is destroying the church today, I would earnestly entreat you to come out of this error and regard the spirit of prophecy as you would regard the Bible. For the Bible says, "The testimony of Jesus is the spirit of prophecy." Revelation 19:10.
Thou art mighty, O Strength and shield, be thou still my strength.